Hi there, in today's video we're gonna look at the swept back wings and the rectangular wings. We're gonna talk about what are the differences and why the airliners have these swept back wings and the aircraft such as the flying school aircraft like the Cessna 172, they have this type of rectangular wings. We're gonna look at the differences, the pros and the cons. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Hi there, my name is Gabriele and I help you to become a better pilot. So if you're new to the channel, welcome. If you're not new, welcome back. If you really want to get better as a pilot and understand better the aviation world, please consider subscribe. And if you want to support the channel, it is very important to give it a like to the video. All right, so let's talk about the swept-back and the rectangular wings. Okay, what are them? Why we've got this type of wings? First of all, we need to think and understand that there is no a perfect wing for all type of aircraft. When the aircraft manufacturer actually is building up the plane, okay, is designing the plane, we need to know what type of operations the plane will perform. Okay, so if an aircraft has to fly fast, okay, and has to go high altitude and high speed, he needs this type of swept back wings. And if an aircraft has to operate in a slow speed environment, such as the Cessna 172 or the very famous Canadair CL415 that operates in a firefighting operations, they requires a complete different type of wings. Okay. So first of all, as you can see, the swept-back wings, they have these arrow shapes, okay? These arrow type of things, the shape of the wings, actually will allow the aircraft to fly faster, okay? Because on the swept-back and the airliners, as you know, or as you may not know, the aircraft, the airliners, they try to fly as fast as they can. However, they always try to remain the subsonic range. Why? Because if we fly in the supersonic range, there will be a lot of drags and a lot of aerodynamics factors come into play. Thus, it's not really worth it to fly slightly faster, but because we're gonna burn a lot more fuel due to the drag. Okay, so the target of the airliner is to fly as close as possible to Mach 1, but not go into the supersonic speed. Okay, so what happened with the swept-back wings? Okay, with the swept-back wings, allow the airliners. Airliner jet to fly as close as possible to Mach 1. In order to understand why we have these swept-back wings on an airliners is because there is something called Mach critic. The Mach critic is extremely important because if you think about an aircraft that is flying on a cruise level, okay, and you are flying, you are the pilot, you read your airspeed indicator is the same Mach 0.85 as a speed of a physical aircraft, okay, that doesn't mean that you will not get into Mach 1.0 and thus going to the supersonic flow, supersonic speed, because we need to know that around the aircraft there is this air flow that goes on top of the wings and around the fuselage that has got a different speed compared with the speed of the actual aircraft, okay. Because as you know, on the airfoil, okay, the part of the airflow that goes on top of the wing actually accelerates. Thus, if that accelerates, that part of the airflow will have an higher speed compared to the aircraft speed, okay? So the Mach critic is the speed at which the pilot has to fly below in order to make sure that the airflow around the airplane won't reach Mach 1.0. Okay, so this is very important, and with the swept-back wings will allow us to fly as close as possible to Mach 1.0 without actually exceeding the Mach critic. Okay, because if you take into consideration, let's just imagine, okay, you take a Cessna 172 and a Boeing 737, okay, so the Cessna 172 has got these rectangular wings and the Boeing 737 has got these swept-back wings. Okay, so if you put both aircraft at Mach 0.85, what will happen is that because of the rectangular type of wing, okay, the Cessna will reach the supersonic flow somewhere around the plane, somewhere around the fuselage, the wings and so on, a lot earlier compared to the Boeing 737 that has got these swept-back wings. So, but these swept-back wings, okay, doesn't come with a downside, okay, because the downside of the swept wing is the low speed, okay, so as you can see, it is very important that you know what type of operations the aircraft needs to do before building up the plane. Okay, so if you need a fast plane, you want to have a swept back wings, because in cruise at high speed is the is the most is gonna spend there the most of the time. However, the sweat wings, okay, they are not good when you fly slow because they have high stall speed, and in generally they are not very stable at low speed compared to the rectangular type of wings on the Cessna or the Canadair and so on. They are very bad at high speed because they reach the Mach 1.0, the supersonic flow, very quickly. However, at slow speed they are very good because they produce a lot of lift. Okay, so as you can see, it is really, you need to think about what I want. Okay, so, and that's what they, the manufacturer, actually do when they build up a new plane. They ask themselves, do we need a fly a fast plane or do we need a slow plane? So, and then depending the aircraft, they build up the wings according to that. So we can close up the video by saying that the swept-back wings are good for high altitude and high speed operations, and the rectangular wings such as the Cessna 172 are good for low speed operations. Okay, I will make very soon a video where we discuss the Mach critic and why we actually, with the swept-back wings, we can have an higher Mach critic. Okay, but in the meantime, guys, if you have any question, leave a comment below and I will help you out. Also go to paloclimb.com where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. I wish you a great day and I'll see you in the next one.